Today we will be going over the device menu for the Model 3001. To enter the device menu, the instrument will need to be off. You will then turn the device on. First, the startup screen will be displayed, followed by the firmware version and the battery voltage. Finally, once the normal operation display is displayed, you will have a 4-second window to enter the device menu by pressing the mode button 3 times. Once inside the mode button, it will indicate which detector is active, which right now is detector 4. If I wanted to make changes to detector 1, I would press the detector button until D-1 is displayed. Once the correct detector is displayed, pressing the units button will enter into the parameter page selection. In page 1, you will find all the calibration specific parameters, like the calibration constant value, the calibration mantissa, the dead time correction in microseconds, the efficiency, the high voltage set point, the pulsar threshold, the detector current overload. If you'll notice on the screen, I have one hash mark that is flashing. That indicates which parameter in that page that I am currently on, which is P1-7. Holding the units button for approximately 3 seconds should exit back to the parameter page selection. By pressing the mode button, page 2 is now available. Page 2 contains all the primary units information. Pressing the units button again will access that page of the device menu. Currently, the alarm parameter is activating. If I wanted to change the alarm maximum display from 500 microAr to say 1 MR, I would use the left button, which is the OK. Pressing the mode button until 1 is displayed. Pressing the OK button one more time, you see nothing is flashing, which means I'm on my decimal position. So pressing the mode button will move my decimal place over. And left one more time will activate the units. And pressing the mode button once will get me to MR per hour. So I've effectively changed my maximum display from 500 microAr to 1 MR. Again, holding the units button for approximately 3 seconds will exit this page. Page 3 will contain all your secondary unit information, exactly the same as page 2, but for the second unit. Page 4 will contain all your device specific information, like your response time and your count time and audio modes. So to change my scalar time, I'm going to access page 4, parameter 4 in page 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 should be my scalar time. I'm going to change this from 6 seconds to 1 minute. Using the mode button, I will increment that number up, the OK button to move left, and the mode button to go up by 1. And holding the units button for approximately 5 seconds should exit the menu completely. If you have a data logging instrument, there will be 5 pages instead of 4, and also before accessing the menu, right after the battery voltage, you will see another number that indicates the number of stored records. Immediately after your stored records are displayed, you will hit the mode button 3 times in order to access the menu. If Sigma Audio is enabled, your normal operation screen will start with an 8-second countdown. As soon as you see the 8-second countdown, you will need to push the mode button 3 times in order to access the menu. Inside all of our user's manuals, you will find a detailed list of each parameter that is in the device menu and where it is at. If for some reason you get into the device menu and none of the digits are blinking, your instrument is probably in protect mode. And once in protect mode, you are unable to make any changes through the device menu. You can open the can and turn the dip switch to off in order to remove it from protect mode so that you can make changes.